serpents in order that the word of Almighty Yah be not blasphemed.
Yes, 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 yes.
But now you got mamas and daddies in the same clubs with their sons and daughters. The son might go to a strip joint and see his daddy making it rain. Yeah, preacher's supposed to know a little bit of everything. Isn't that right, Brother Ben?
That is true.
I ain't never made it rain, but I know they got some out there making it rain. Hey, that's stupid. Going to the casino, spending up all your money. For what? A chance. You can put $100 a week in a small jar called a mason jar. And you can save more money in that mason jar in a year's time than you're going to make in the casino in 2 years. Because whatever you make in the casino, you're going to give it back. That's what's causing the nation to fall. Well, it don't look like it. But you destroy the family structure and you lose society. You lose society and you lose a city. You lose a city and you lose a country. And that's what's going on in this country right now. The scripture says, likewise, urge your young men to be sensible. We got some young men in here. I'm not going to call nobody over Shandon's age. I'm going to talk about Jaden and I'm going to talk about Shandon. Young men. Jaden burst out singing and giving praises to the Father today.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shandon burst out and took the mic and sung one by himself.
Yeah.
They read scripture. They pray prayers right here in front of you elders. Hallelujah. But how many of us are contributing to the prayer to sustain them? To keep them out of the coffers of Satan himself. That the Father will build a bulwark around these young men.
Hallelujah.
But the minute they do something stupid, you're ready to jump on them. Talk about it. Put them down. When it's time for us to be lifting them up.
Look what Yah has
done. But the nation is falling right now. Because we're not doing our part. In Matthew 19:6, it says, so that they are no longer two, but one flesh. That means husband and wife got to be one flesh. Therefore, what the Almighty has joined together, let no man separate them. No man should separate them. Or if we would have learned this stuff when we were younger, some of us wouldn't even be here. But we didn't learn. Ironically enough, it's a bad thing that the only way you can learn, you got to get the hell beat out you.
Yeah, we're too.
Then you're ready to learn something. But when the Father giving you some knowledge, giving you some wisdom, giving you some understanding prior to anything you might involve yourself with, why don't you listen? Why don't the president pray? Why don't he surround himself with prophets and evangelists and pastors and teachers? Why in the White House filled with the word of Almighty God? We are not a scriptural country.
No.
This is a place of sin and degradation. Shame. They won't even let America make commercials in some countries. Because our commercials are filled with lewdness. And we walk around here, I am an American. Is that something to be proud of? Brother Adam, what can you say? Well, I'm going to tell you what I can say. At 18 years old, I was over there being shot at and shooting at for this country. I'm a veteran. I tasted war. I saw what war do. I felt it. I felt fear for the first time in my life. I'm talking about ultimate abject fear. Because you never know over there when you're coming back or not.
Yeah.
You got to live with it every day and every night.
Every day.
And I'm standing here telling you this, what I see in this country is not what I fought for. Not what I almost surrendered my life for. So I joined another country.
Come on now.
Yeah. Remember that country is the kingdom of Almighty God.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I have a king in place who is never going to be deposed.
Yeah.
He is there forever.
Hallelujah.
And he's getting ready to take over this country and every other nation on this planet. I am an ambassador to the kingdom of Almighty God.
Yes.
And I stand strong in my faith.
Yeah.
We need America to wake up. Families, wake up.
Yes.
And stop making divorce courts rich.
Yes, indeed.
Stop letting your children be trained by strangers.
Mm-hmm.
Stop letting your women, stop letting your husband be handled by other women. And men, stop letting your wives be handled by other men. Stop being stupid. Because you're in a nation that's coming down. And when it comes down, my Father's kingdom will rise up.
Hey, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And if you're found in the wrong place at the wrong time with the wrong people, you're going to hell.
Yes,
indeed.
That's right.
I'm only trying to help you.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to hurt anybody. Because you know back in the day, you can read about it in the book of Deuteronomy. If you want to read about it, Deuteronomy 24, Moses gave them permission to write a bill of divorcement.
Yeah.
That's when it all started. When did he do that? Give a bill of divorcement and put that woman away. Matthew 19:8 says, he said to them, because of the hardness of your heart.
Yeah.
Moses allowed you to put away your wives. But from the beginning, it was not so. So somebody made that to come into the mix, and they shouldn't be there. Whatever the Father and joined together stays together, and it becomes one. When you go to the divorce court, you're going against the Almighty God. Are y'all hearing me? When you go to the divorce court, you're hurting yourself, you're hurting your children, you're hurting your parents, you're hurting your in-laws, and all of the outlaws. Everybody suffers. The country suffers. I hope somebody's listening. You got to have a hard heart to have a divorce. Hallelujah. Now I don't think nobody's heart was harder than mine. But the Father has given me a tenderizer.
Hallelujah.
We thank you.
Hallelujah. Been with Sister Williams almost 40 years.
Hallelujah.
The Father let me find the good thing.
Yes, he did.
And he also let me find favor with him. We are not to follow the ways of mere men. So he says, whatever I say to you, I need you to listen. Whosoever puts away his wife, except on the ground of whoring herself, and marries anybody else, he commits adultery and causes her to live in it. And whoever marries her who is living in adultery commits adultery. So now you see there's sin that's emitting from divorce courts. Sin is being propagated throughout the country. Because you got all these second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth marriages going on by the same people. And they're spreading sin all over the country. Jeremiah 6, verse number 16 says, thus saith Almighty God, stand in the way and see and ask for the old paths. That's where the good way is. And walk in it and find rest for yourself. But they said, we're not going to do that. We ain't doing it. We ain't going back to the old ways. Let me tell you one. I talked to some young people. You know what they say? Brother Ali, that's the old school. We don't do it like that. Yeah, that's why you're going now. You're going broke right now. Because, see, they don't understand when you go to a divorce court, you got to pay a lawyer, then you got to pay the court system, and then you got to pay child support, and then you got to pay alimony, and then you got to pay for that same building you were living in, now you got to pay for what they ain't living in. I'm going to give you a little secret. It's cheaper to keep it.
That is true.
All right, Bobby Blue.
That's the truth.
Hallelujah.
But what else can cause a nation to fall? Well, not having the proper educational system, especially in the things of the Most High. Our children are not learning worthwhile information in school. I mean, mathematics, Brother Warren, I can't knock you. You know, they need mathematics. They need English and reading. They need that up to a certain point.
Yeah.
But they got my brother here teaching calculus. I don't know too many people are going to use calculus to go buy food at the store.
No, they don't.
I don't need calculus to buy gas. But I do need to know 1 + 1 = 2. And I know $1 is 10% of $10. But it don't take calculus to fill that out.
Yes, sir.
But I respect the office of my brother because he is teaching what they deem to be necessary to keep up with other countries. In case y'all didn't know what that was all about. Just to keep up with other countries. We are teaching this foolishness to our children. We don't need the metric system over here. But now that's being taught in place of simple math. We look at the thermometer and we used to say Fahrenheit. But now we're seeing Celsius. We don't need that. We did good without that a long time ago. The country was built on that a long time ago. One time they come, oh, you need some oil, Brother Williams? I got some. You need some water, Brother John? Yeah, I got some. Well, give me some of your oil, and I'll give you some of my water. Call a bartering system. The country worked well. Now, you don't shake hands no more because everybody lying. You don't even trust the man you living next door to. So how can you do what the scripture says that says, love your neighbor as you love yourself? You don't even know. The country is going down. What about children? What did the Father say about our education? He said in Hosea chapter 4, verse number 6, he said, right up here, my people are destroyed. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Is that what he said?
Yes, sir.
He said, I reject you from being priests for me since you have forgotten the law of your Elohim. So since you've forgotten that, I will also forget your children. There go the country right there. Because if you leave in this country to the children that's coming from you, you are steeped in foolishness. You are steeped in doing something ignorant. You are steeped in lies.